Here's my heart, please make it yours. I give my love to you. We are two become one.
That's awesome. You're just so excited.
No, I'm just gonna wait anymore.
That's awesome.
I don't care.
Well, friends and family, we are here today to worship God, and we're here today to witness the vows of Jeph Fred Matuka and Ashley Victoria Gruber. You know, I love weddings and I love this setting that we're in right now because it's a way for us as humans to actually identify with God, because God is love. And we get to see these two lovebirds right here become one today, and we get to see just love really in action. And it's amazing to be here. I'm honored to be here. Let's pray. Father, I thank you for Jeph. I thank you for Ashley. I thank you for the paths that you have taken them on to their lives, that has led them all the way to this moment right here, that the two shall actually become one. And Father, I pray that you would seal these vows that we say today in their hearts. Lord, I know that you're here. I know that your presence is here, because where two or three are gathered, you are in the midst. And so, Father, we're excited that we get to witness something that you instituted today. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. Well, I know these two, and I know that they love Jesus and they love God, and they want God to be in their wedding. And I love that about them. The beautiful thing is that God is here. And one of the reasons God's here is because He actually instituted marriage. You have to go all the way back to the garden. And I love thinking about this. God created everything, created the birds and the bees. He created the ground we stand on. He created everything, and He created man. And there was one thing, and after He created everything, He said it was very good. But there was one thing that He said was not good. And this is actually the place where marriage came out of. Because I believe that God created us with this desire for connection and for relationship. And I want to read this verse. It's actually in Genesis 2:18, and I like the way the New Living Translation reads. It says, "Then the Lord God said, it is not good for man to be alone." Thank you, Jesus. "It is not good for man to be alone. I will make a helper who is just right for him." I love the way it says, "who is just right for him." You know, Jeph, Ashley is just right for you, and Ashley, Jeph is just right for you. And I love that we have been created in a way for connection and relationship, and we get to see you two become one today. You know, in the garden, we saw how Adam left his father to join Eve, and they became one. And today we get to see Jeph leave his father and mother to be joined to Ashley. And also we get to see Ashley leave her father and mother to be joined to Jeph. With that being said, who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Ashley's mother and I.
So be it. Two can stand right here. Well, Jeph, Ashley, I just want you to breathe in just for a second. This is your wedding. You have made it here. And I'm just so proud of you two. And I know that obviously with all the circumstances going on with the COVID-19 virus, and you know, at first we thought we were gonna be able to have 500, then we thought we were gonna be able to have 250, and then it dropped down to like 50, and then 25, and then in Jefferson County it was 10. And I know that my heart just went out for you guys throughout this whole process. But I know that there's something beautiful when God takes beauty out of ashes, and He takes joy out of mourning, and that God actually works all things for our good. And I know that there's probably people in here that can relate to this as well, but in my own life, there's been many hard circumstances that I walked through that I would never ask on somebody, but what God did in me, I would never trade. And what God did through it, I would just never trade. And I really believe that this is a special moment because of your perseverance, because you're like, man, I'm not letting some virus stop me from getting married. We're gonna do this because we really do love each other. And I just commend y'all for that. And I believe God's grace and beauty is all over this. So I'm excited to be a part of this. Jeph takes three yeses to have a marriage, has God's yes, your yes, and thank you, Jesus, that she said yes. Yes, I got to do premarital counseling with these two amazing people, and I got to see Jeph and his personality, and I've known Jeph, and he's a fun, loving, just encouraging guy. I mean, if you just need some encouragement, you get around Jeph. And I've gotten to know Ashley, and she's a pioneer. She's a doer, she's a get-it-done type girl, and I just love seeing these two personalities become one today. In premarital, I've seen their authenticity, I've seen their honesty, I've seen how they've navigated through things well, even few things we asked them to do, like every single one of them, they were like, we're going to do it. And I've just been so proud of you two in this process. It's been so beautiful to watch. And the thing that means the most to me, and I would probably say most of us here, is that Jesus is at the center of this. And that we know that that's the most important thing, that His presence in Him is at the center of y'all's marriage. I want to read a verse here. It's a verse a lot of times read at weddings, but I just felt like there was a phrase in here that is for y'all. And this is 1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 7. It says, love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and it keeps no record of being wrong. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up. We can just speak a testimony to that this week. Come on, we didn't give up. Love never gives up, never loses faith. Come on. It always is hopeful. And I just love this little phrase in the way the New Living Translation says this. It endures through every circumstance. And we've gotten to see y'all's love endure through every circumstance, even through this circumstance. And I just feel one little, maybe a little prophetic thing over you guys is I just feel like you are going to learn how to navigate circumstances in a really good way in your life. You're already doing it. I've already seen it. And I believe that even other couples and other people, y'all are eventually going to help other people walk through tough circumstances because of the way that y'all are navigating things so well. And so I just encourage you with that. I believe God's going to use y'all in a significant way in that way. Well, today you're entering into a covenant of marriage. You know, what this means is that it's a coming together. It's a choice that both of y'all are making to come into this marriage. If you think about it, out of all the 3 billion dudes on the earth, however many there are, you're the one. And out of all the 3 billion or so girls on the earth, you're saying you're the one. And that's such a beautiful thing to see y'all today. You know, in the Bible, there was 4 covenants in the Old Testament, and then there's the new covenant that Jesus, that we see God do through Jesus. And Jesus is our example. And there's 2 things that I would say in a covenant that Jesus modeled. One is that I'll never leave you nor forsake you. And in your vows, that's really what one of the things in sickness and in health, in hard times and good times, it's a covenant that I'm like, hey, I'm with you, and I'm with you all the way. And then the other part of that is that I'm giving my life. You know, like Jesus showed us, like He, you know, stepped off the throne, came onto the earth, and He gave everything for us. And really, that's what a covenant is. It's like, hey, I'm in this, in the good times and the bad times, in the sick times and in the well times, that I'm never going to leave you and I'm never going to forsake you. And I just love that y'all are choosing to step into that kind of relationship today. That's the commitment that you're making. So my last little charge to you before we make this final, and I think these are things that you guys are already doing. You know, you get to make a choice here. You're entering into a covenant. In your life and in your marriage, you get to choose. Are we going to have a good, healthy covenant? Or are we going to have a tough covenant? And obviously we all know people that are married that we walk through conflict and hard times. But there are some things that we can do to cultivate an amazing marriage. And one of those is to lean into the one that brought you together. Lean into God. He's the center of this thing, and in all of this, He's our strength, He's our rock. The other thing I would say is move towards each other in love. You're about to make that vow that even in conflict and when I'm hurt and in those times, I just encourage you to move towards each other in love. And the last thing is, and I've seen this in y'all, is honesty. Honesty builds trust and intimacy. It's so huge for us in our relationships to really build our marriages off of honesty. And I've seen y'all model that so well, and I just encourage y'all in that. Well, are y'all ready? Or y'all want me to keep talking? I'm just kidding. We're ready. They're ready. I can see it in them. They're ready for this. Y'all have done so well. Jeph, is it truly your intention to have Ashley as your wife, to live exclusively and permanently with her in the holy covenant of marriage? If so, say, I do.
I do.
Come on. Ashley, do you want Jeph to be your husband, to live exclusively and permanently together with him in the holy covenant of marriage? If so, say, I do.
I do.
I love it. These two have chosen to obviously say their vows here today, and they're going to repeat after me. And Jeph, we'll start with you. Jeph, you can repeat after me. And so, in the presence of God, our family, and friends.
In the presence of God and our family and friends.
I, Jeph. Take you, Ashley, as my wife.
Take you, Ashley, as my wife.
To be. What?
Sorry.
I love it. Yeah, wife is the right. Wife is the right word. There you go. You got it. You're doing great. To be no other than yourself.
To be no other than yourself.
Loving what I know of you.
Loving what I know of you.
Trusting what I do not yet know.
Trusting what I do not know yet. Not yet.
There you go. I will respect your integrity.
I will respect your integrity.
And have faith in your abiding love for me. And have faith.
And have faith.
In your abiding love for me.
Abiding love for me.
Through all the years.
Through all the years.
And in all that life may bring us. And in all that life may bring us.
All that life may bring us.
I promise to you.
I promise to you.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
For poorer.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
In health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Come on. Ashley, repeat after me. In the presence of God, our family and friends.
In the presence of God, our family and friends.
I, Ashley.
I, Ashley.
Take you, Jeph.
Take you, Jeph.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
And honest with you.
And honest with you.
I promise to forgive you.
I promise to forgive you.
As we have been forgiven.
As we have been forgiven.
I promise to honor and love you.
I promise to honor and love you.
In times that are easy.
In times that are easy.
And in times that are hard.
And in times that are hard.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
For poorer.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Come on. That's so good. That's so good. Yeah. That's awesome. Well, how about we put some rings on those fingers? We'll start with you, Jeph. I love the ring. You know, it's a picture of, there's no disconnection in this, and it's really a symbol of the covenant that we're walking into, that you two are walking into today. And I love this. And so, Jeph, one more time, you're just going to repeat after me. Jeph, take that little band, look her in the eye, and say, Ashley.
Ashley.
I give this ring.
I give this ring.
As an outward token.
An outward token.
Of the covenant.
Of the covenant.
I make with you.
I make with you.
Before God and man.
Before God and man.
Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Son.
In the name of the Son.
In the name of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. You may put the ring on the finger. Come on. So good. Ashley, grab your Skittles. Take that Skittle. Put it in his mouth. Absolutely.
They're both red.
Yeah. Ooh, I like that ring, Jeph. That's a.
I know. That is a.
That's got a little hip to it, buddy. You're gonna be looking sharp. Ashley, take the ring. Look Jeph in the eye and repeat after me, Jeph.
Jeph.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As an outward token.
As an outward token.
Of the covenant.
Of the covenant
that I make with you,
that I make with you,
before God and man,
before God and man,
receive this ring,
receive this ring,
in the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
in the name of the Son,
in the name of the Son,
and in the name of the Holy Spirit,
in the name of the Holy Spirit.
Come on. And they fit. Let's pray. Father, I just thank you that you instituted marriage between a man and a woman. That, Lord, this is something so sacred that we get to enter into together. That this is something, God, again, that you created for us to experience. And Father, I just bless these two. I bless their marriage. Lord, just as you say, be fruitful and multiply. Father, we just bless them with that. And Lord, I pray that you would cover them and be with them. And Lord, I pray that this would be a marriage, even as they have persevered and walked through a tough situation, Lord, that they would bring hope to this world, that love does endure and love never fails. And so we bless them in their marriage in Jesus' name. Amen. Jeph and Ashley, one thing I'd like to just say to the community real quick and anybody on Facebook Live that's a part of the Oak City family, let's wave at the camera. Hey, everybody, we love you. We're so glad that you were able to join us via Facebook Live or wherever you are in your home. I know these two are honored to have you online, but I just want to encourage everybody as a community to wrap your arms around them, to support them, to encourage them, that in the good times and in the hard times, that we would cover them in prayer and we'd also just be available to them, to love them as they walk out this marriage. With that being said, you know, in the presence of God and in the presence of all these people and in the presence of Facebook Live as well, you know, in the blessing of God, it is my pleasure to pronounce you husband and wife. Jeph, you may kiss your bride. You know, it is my honor, it really is my honor, to introduce to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Jeph Matuka. The tunes. Yeah. That's awesome. So good.